Parmesan herb and mustard. Flavor with a twist.
Howard Hughes lived the American dream. He was wealthy beyond belief, dated beautiful movie stars, and made record-breaking flights. But the man who could have it all for years just wanted to be left alone. Because of that, much of his life has remained a mystery until now. Author Richard Hack uncovers America's first billionaire in his new book, simply called Hughes. Hack, good morning. Good to see you.
Thank God.
You said, I'm fine, thank you. You said this is a different perspective on Howard Hughes because the other books have been written based on stories told by people who knew him. You think this is his point of view. How could that be?
Well, I made the effort to try to get inside of his mind. But this is he was America's first a billionaire. And he was a famous film producer after all. You'll recall The Outlaw with J. Russell and Brass, and he won the first Oscar Award for Best Comedy Film. He also flew around the world, setting records. He also won in Las Vegas, and he also was America's number one defense contractor. And he dated all those beautiful women that you know, Katharine Hepburn,
right,
and Lionel Turner. But the fact was, this is a man that absolutely was elusive.
Live pictures are SkyCam that is looking at one of the World Trade Center buildings from Lower Manhattan. You can see that there has been some sort of damage to this building. At this point, we do not know exactly what happened. We have had an eyewitness named Tony Arrigo, who was on East 12th Street, looked up into the sky, and he says it appears to him that an airplane struck the upper portion of that building. We are now going to go to Mary Corza on the telephone, who is another eyewitness. Mary, can you tell us what you saw? Mary? Mary, are you there?
I am here.
Mary, can you please tell us what you saw and where you are?
I'm at 14th Street and 5th Avenue, and we saw a plane flying low overhead, which caught all of our attention. We looked up, it was making a beeline to the World Trade Center. It was very low, extremely low. Not a big plane like an airliner, but not a tiny propeller plane either, a small jet plane.
We can now see flames coming from the building. It appeared to you that the airplane was directly aimed at the World Trade Center?
It did appear that way to many of us that were here on the ground, yes.
Okay.
And in case there was a big boom, a big cloud of smoke, some flames, and then mostly smoke. It just started flaming now.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm shaking. Can't do this anymore.
you see a second room right into it along the truck. You got right out of there.
here. I'm not going.